Tracy Letts. Tracy is the screenwriter. You're a man of many hats. I mean, you've done acting, you've done screenwriting, you do so many different things. This is a very interesting journey on this film, starting off on stage, and correct me if I'm wrong, 14 years, I guess, since kind of the initial germination of it being on stage, and now it's on the big screen. You know, it has to have been a very interesting journey, I would imagine, from start to finish to get this done.
It's kind of a mind-blowing journey. Actually, I first wrote the play in 1990. It was first staged in 1993, and I thought when we first did it, it was going to run for 4 weeks in a 40-seat house in Evanston, Illinois, that it has continued to have life all these years later, and now a movie is beyond my wildest expectations for it.
Yeah, and you guys had a really great reaction at the Toronto International Film Festival. A lot of people have been talking about this and saying what a fascinating and amazing film it is. I mean, that's got to be very gratifying too, I would imagine.
It's terrific. You know, it provokes such strong reactions in people, either positive or negative. So to sit in a theater and sort of feel the boat rocking back and forth is very exciting, very gratifying.
How about these actors, watching them realize these characters on the big screen? Is it like everything you ever wanted it to be as far as their personification of what you wrote?
They're a great bunch. Each one of them brings something individually to the stew that's just really, really good. I mean, nobody's making fun of anything here. Nobody's mocking anything here. I mean, everybody's playing it very straight and very real, and they're all giving really wonderful performances.
Very good. Well, thank you for bringing us to South by Southwest. Appreciate you coming out.
Thanks
good
a
talking
lot.
To you.
Appreciate it.
Hi, Gina. I'm Mark. Very nice to meet you.
Hi, nice to meet
BigFanboy.com.
Okay.
Yeah, very nice to see you.
What are you? What fan talk?
BigFanboy.com. I know.
That's a good one.
It sounds ridiculous, doesn't it?
Are you the big fanboy?
I am the big fanboy. I'm the big fanboy that started it. So.
Good for you.
I'm here with the very lovely Gina Gershon. It's such a pleasure to meet you because I've admired your work for many, many years.
Oh, thank you.
This seems like, I was just talking to Tracy about this, it seems like a really interesting journey starting out on stage, finally coming to the big screen.
Mm-hmm.
Really daring film. I would imagine that, you know, it seems like you tend to play a lot of these very, I don't want to say risky, but fascinating roles. And this is probably no exception, I would think, too.
Yeah. This, you know, it's true. I do like characters who are a little bit out there, and it's a little bit scary. But this one, when I first read it as a play, because they asked me to possibly do it, it even scared me. So I just said, oh, God, I can't do that 8 shows a week. That's just too much. And then when it came, but it always bugged me because it's the one thing I turned down. It's the one thing I just said that scared me that I didn't want to do. And so when it came up later as a movie, I thought, oh, it's that play. It's that thing. I have to do it. You know, I really have to get over it. And, you know, of course, with Friedkin and the cast. You know.
Talk about working with Bill Friedkin because he's a fascinating director as well. I mean,
You know, he's unlike any director I've ever worked with. You know, he's super old school. But he's such a crazy character, you know. But he could walk into a room and know exactly what he wants, how he wants it. I mean, I was lucky to get 2 takes because he would, you know, you talk about it and he knows what he wants and you do it. And it's like, great, let's go. Oh, the basketball game's on 6. Okay, it's a wrap. I mean, he's pretty incredible.
Yeah. I know we got to go. Thank you for coming to South by Southwest.
Thank you.
Hey, Emil, Mark Walters.
Hey,
nice to meet you, man. You and I have a mutual friend in Scott Porter.
Oh, yes, yeah, Scott.
Yeah. He told me a great story about you guys in Berlin when you were shooting Speed Racer and Goodman sliding some guy into the bathroom. Do you remember that at all?
I don't expect you to.
But we're here for Killer Joe, South by Southwest. apparently the ambulances or the cops are coming to get us. I don't know what's going on over there. But what's the vibe been like for you guys with this movie? I mean, this is a really cool project, you know, kind of a long germinating project starting in the 90s as a play and then eventually getting made into a movie.
A lot of Germans. I think I'm just stoked to be here. I mean, it's Tracy's first play, and I can't believe, you know, they let him make it into a movie. It's pretty wacky and wild.
It's been quite a journey for him, too.
Yeah, and it's, you know, it's pretty controversial and pretty crazy, but I think that's why people like it. You know, it was a big success on Broadway, I think partially because it is so crazy and out there, and people just have a wild time at the theater.
And you had a good reaction at Toronto International Film Festival as well. People have been talking about the movie quite a bit. I would imagine it's got to be really gratifying. To me, it seems like the film festival reactions in some way, that's a really interesting way to kind of gauge how, you know, the average audience is going to take to it as well.
Yeah, I mean, I guess each film festival is a little different, and the mentality at all the festivals are a little different. And I don't know, I've never been to South by Southwest, but, you know, like I'm a big fan of, you know, like Ain't It Cool and all that, and I think that they'll... they seem like this would be a movie right up their alley. You know, they like movies like Blood Simple. And, you know, it seems like a pretty South by Southwest kind of movie.
I'd love to see you do some work with the Coen brothers, springing up Blood Simple.
Yeah, me too.
Yeah. Let's make that happen.
Yeah,
we'll start a campaign for
calls.
It. Thanks for coming to South by Southwest. Yeah. It's good to meet you. Hey, Matthew,
hey,
Mark. Very nice to meet you.
How about you?
I'm here with Matthew, the main man McConaughey. That's my nickname for you now. I'm going to give you
the
that.
The main man on
that's
that.
Right. Yeah.
Need to go into the WWF.
We're at South by Southwest. Killer Joe, this is a nice kind of edgy, sort of a nice change of pace. Is it kind of fun to sink your teeth into kind of a, this is more serious type
Yeah,
of thing,
I mean, it's its own kind of hyper-reality, but it's fun to do different things, man. I've done some comedies. I've done some romantic comedies. This is... You could call it a comedy, but it's not really a romantic comedy. You could call it a love story, but it's a whole different kind of love story. It's really well-written stuff. Tracy Letts, the playwright, wrote it. William Friedkin, the guy I wanted to work with, is behind the helm of the director. So it was good stuff to work with.
Yeah, I mean, it's a great mixture of guys behind it. I mean, you're working with a guy like Friedkin. I mean, this guy's a legend in the industry. Yeah. I mean, any kind of stories you can share about, like, experiences, particular experiences working with him?
Super fun to work with, man. All right, well, here's the thing. One take.
Yeah, yeah. That's
all
what Gino was saying.
All right. And you want two, we'll just do it for safety, but we don't really need it for safety. But if you want two, I'll give it, but that's it. You don't need more.
Yeah.
That was fun because it keeps the set vital. You just, you know, you show up and as soon as you walk on set, press record, get it on. That's fun to work that way.
I know they got to keep you going. My mother, Helen, is a huge fan. Can you just say hi to Helen real quick?
Hey, Helen. Just keep living. All right.
Oh, she's going to love that. Thank you, man. Appreciate it.